Welcome back. OpenMW version 0.25 has been released. Let's have a look at some of the progress that's been made since the last release. OpenMW now makes use of the records that specify the sounds produced by creatures and NPCs. Basically, creatures should now make all the little creature noises you'd expect them to, and NPCs produce footstep sounds and such. The AI package, AI Wander, has been implemented. As you might expect, this is what allows NPCs to wander around town and so forth. Currently, this command must be invoked by way of the in-game console, but of course, this behavior will be initialized on startup in a future version. When playing in windowed mode, OpenMW now loses exclusive control of the mouse cursor when the game is paused. This allows one to easily and quickly switch between the game and other applications, say an internet browser with OpenMW's bug tracker open. You know, for testing OpenMW and filing bug reports. If you're watching this and have not yet done so, you might consider testing OpenMW and filing a bug report or two if you find anything suspicious. First-person animations are now implemented. The player may now see their hands ready to do all the things that player hands typically do in Morrowind from the first-person perspective. This will obviously become much more exciting once the various combat and spellcasting systems are implemented. You can do some first-person lockpicking in the meantime. Also, there is a very large chance that once melee combat is implemented, the abysmal excuse for a Bosmer that you now see in front of you will be the first NPC murdered legitimately on this channel. Leave suggestions for other Morrowind inhabitants to be killed in cold blood in the comments below. The player may now zoom in and out in the third-person view using their mouse wheel if they have one. This feature was not present in vanilla Morrowind. Slider buttons now auto-repeat after you've clicked them as long as you keep the button pressed down. It's a small convenience, sure, but it's a nice thing to have, and it's another thing crossed off the roadmap towards OpenMW 1.0. Speaking of conveniences, the user may now close open containers by pressing the activation key again, which is almost certainly faster than clicking the close button with the cursor as one must do in vanilla Morrowind. Other than what's been shown in this video, a 64-bit version of OpenMW will now be available for macOS 10. Additionally, OpenMW now uses the hardware cursor rather than rendering one in software. This makes the cursor frame rate independent so the user will not experience cursor lag when their frame rate drops below average. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, and stay tuned for future updates. In the meantime, keep in mind that you can visit our website, openmw.org, which features weekly blog posts, our official forums, and our bug and feature tracker, among other things. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.